The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O risen Lord, we gather today to celebrate the life that you have given to us. We gather today, O God, as a people of faith, knowing that you have come into this world for us to believe in you in order for us to have life and have it even more abundantly. As we celebrate and worship you today, may our worship be one which reminds us that we are called to have that trust in you. We are called to believe in you, bearing in mind that in spite of the struggles or obstacles that we go through, you will always bring us through. And so we put this service now into your hands, as we ask you to speak to our hearts, and so challenge our wills, through the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The hymn for the procession, 180, 180.
Souls and bodies as a living sacrifice, and eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen.
Almighty God, to you our hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name,
through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Chapter 2, beginning at verse 14a to 22 to 32. Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with deeds of power, wonders, and signs that God did through him among you. As you yourselves know, this man handed over to you according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of those outside the law. But God raised him up, having freed him from death, because it was impossible for him to be held in his power. For God says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh will live in hope, for you will not abandon my soul to hate, or let your Holy One experience corruption. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Fellow Israelites, I may say to you confidently of our ancestor David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Since he was a prophet, he knew that God had sworn with an oath to him that he would put one of his descendants on his throne. Foreseeing this, David spoke of the resurrection of the Messiah, saying, he was not abandoned to his, nor did his flesh experience corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and of that all of us are witness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm appointed for today, Psalm 16, can be found on page 484. I pause at the asterisk. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you.
And I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my God above all other.
All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land.
Upon those who are noble among the people.
But those who run after other gods
shall have their troubles multiplied.
Their libations of blood I will not offer,
nor take the names of their gods upon my lips.
O Lord, you are my portion and my cup.
It is you who uphold my lot.
My boundaries enclose a pleasant land.
Indeed, I have a goodly heritage.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel.
My heart teaches me night after night.
I have set the Lord always before me.
Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall.
My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices.
My body also shall rest in hope.
For you will not abandon me to the grave,
nor let your poor ones see the pit.
You will show me the path of life.
In your presence there is fullness of joy. And in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Reading from the first letter of Peter, chapter 1, reading from verse 3 to 9. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in the heavens for you. You are being protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now for a little while you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith be more precious than gold. Though perishable, it is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him, and even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy, for you are receiving the outcome of your faith through the salvation of your soul. The word of the Lord.
The gradual hymn 177. 177.
Oh, yeah.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to Christ, our Savior.
When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hands in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you may have life in his name. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise Christ, O Lord.
Life. From the moment you trusted Christ, you had a positive, peaceful, and right standing relationship with God in Christ. People cannot be saved by their good works or sincere efforts, he explains, but only by the grace of God through repenting of their sins and making a personal decision to trust Christ in faith. Christ bore your sins on the cross. In turn, when God sees you now, he no longer sees the stain of sin, but rather the righteousness of Christ, said Slot. And so as we strive to deepen our faith in Jesus, we are hence reminded in a nutshell that faith is believing in Jesus Christ, depending on him to save you, and trusting he will give you eternal life. Believing in Jesus Christ, depending on him to save you, and trusting he will give you eternal life. In the gospel for today, John 20:19-31, Thomas was doubtful about Jesus being raised from the dead. According to John 20:19, it was evening on the first day of the week, the day of resurrection, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews. Suddenly, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Imagine the astonishment of the disciples as Jesus showed them his hands and his side. This caused the disciples to rejoice as Jesus showed them proof of his resurrection by his pierced hands and side. They were overjoyed that he had been raised from the dead. Their faith in Jesus was therefore restored as they saw for themselves that Jesus was not dead, but was alive and well. According to John 20:21, Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." In saying this, Jesus commissioned the disciples as witnesses of his resurrection to now go out and preach the gospel to all nations. And therefore in verse 22, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." When Jesus had appeared to the disciples this Sunday evening, John 20 verse 24 tells us that Thomas, one of the disciples who was called the twin, was not with them. When he learned that Jesus had appeared to the other disciples, Thomas said to them, "Unless I put my finger through the holes in his hands and my hand in his side, I will not believe it." Clearly, he did not believe that Jesus had really been risen from the dead. It is not surprising that the author of John's Gospel gave this detailed account of the resurrection story. As the intended audience were skeptics, they were rational thinkers, and so in order for them to accept this recollection, it had to seem practical or make sense, as they would have shared similar views to that of Thomas. John 20 verse 26 then tells us that 1 week later, his disciples were again in the house, and this time Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, the text tells us that Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Turning to Thomas, Jesus said to him, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." So amazed was Thomas when he saw Jesus that he exclaimed, "Oh Lord, my God!" Yes, my friends, Thomas had seen and so had now come to believe. Consequently, Jesus said to him, "Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." John 20, verse 29. As Christians, we are regarded as a people of faith because we have come to accept the testimony of others that Jesus has indeed been raised from the dead. Even non-biblical sources attest to this fact, thus further proving that Jesus' resurrection is not a myth, but a reality. From these testimonies and our own, we have been able to experience for ourselves what the risen Christ can do in our own lives, thus further justifying that what they have said about Jesus is very true. And it is for this very reason, my friends, that many of us have come to accept and believe in him and the awesome miracles that he can work in our lives as a people. This, my brothers and sisters, is faith. Trusting and believing that he can make the impossible possible in our daily lives. Luke 18 verse 27 reminds us that what is impossible for people is possible with God.
Amen.
So just as Jesus commissioned the disciples who were sad and distressed because of his death, having proved that he was alive, they were revitalized, they were rejuvenated, and now were empowered to continue the mission that Jesus had called them to embark on, as seen in John 20 verses 21 to 22. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. So in spite of the dampened spirits that we may have as we struggle with this coronavirus, we are called, my brothers and sisters, to celebrate our faith in Jesus by being optimistic, hopeful, and joyful. We cannot allow anything to steal our joy. And so as a people on whom God has breathed the Holy Spirit, we are called to remember 2 Timothy 1 verses 6 to 7. For this reason, I remind you to rekindle the gift of God that is within you through the laying on of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. As a people of faith, we can trust God's guidance and help to take us through the present struggle that we face. Do not doubt, my brothers and sisters. Let us cling to our belief in Jesus. So though we were not there with the disciples to physically witness the great event of the resurrection, in faith we believe that God became flesh, walked this earth as a human being. He died, buried, and rose triumphantly from the grave on the third day. This statement of faith, which is also seen in our creeds, reminds us that our God is not dead, but is alive and well. This we believe in faith. And we're reminded of this every Sunday when we say the Nicene Creed, and during Easter when we use the Apostles' Creed. To believe or accept in faith that Jesus has been raised from the dead, it is a reminder to us of the reality that nothing is too difficult or impossible for Jesus to do in our lives. Thomas was initially doubtful of Jesus' resurrection, but once he saw for himself that Jesus was indeed alive and well, with the holes in his hands and side, he was a different person. And so it is with us, my friends. When we decide to believe experience and accept the risen Christ in our lives, then, my friends, our doubts and despair will also be turned into joy. Therefore, whatever it is that we go through in life, we should never doubt Jesus' ability to, number one, solve our problems. So the question is, what are those issues about which we are anxious? Such that sometimes we believe that there is no way out. What are those struggles that we continue to allow to burden us down day by day? Jesus, my friends, has the ability to solve our problems. Number two, as we go through life in faith, we should never doubt Jesus' ability to help us to turn our lives around and help us to repent from a life of sin. So what are those sinful actions that are preventing us from fully giving our lives to God? In faith, my friends, I want to encourage us today to make that step and turn away from sin. With God's help, we can make this move. In faith, we can enjoy the new life that our resurrected Lord has to share with us all. And so, my friends, we are therefore being encouraged or being challenged to put our trust in Jesus as the one who can help us to turn our lives around so that we can enjoy the fullness of life that he has brought to this world. We don't have to live a life of sin. Jesus is calling us to repent and to give our lives over to him. And number three, whatever it is that we go through in life, we should never doubt Jesus' ability to heal our land. And even as we speak of this COVID-19 virus and or any other illness that is affecting our lives. With the recent increase in the number of COVID-19 cases arising from the BPO in St. Catherine, many of us have become anxious and fearful, and rightly so. But in faith, my brothers and sisters, I want us to remember today that God is still in control. Amen. This is the message of hope from the resurrection. In faith, we believe and know that God will not leave us comfortless, and so will provide a cure, a vaccine in God's own time, so that we can receive God's healing touch. So while we pray for healing in our country, let us also use wisdom and seek to practice the safety protocols in order to preserve our lives. Social distancing, wearing a mask in public, washing hands frequently, using hand sanitizers, and so on. God has given us the Holy Spirit to discern God's will for us. It is only for us to not be ignorant about the coronavirus, but to trust and listen to God's direction so that we can wholeheartedly be led by him to what is right and pleasing to God. My brothers and sisters in Christ, in faith, we can trust Jesus' ability to turn what may seem as a difficult or impossible situation into a joyful occasion. Jim Wallace reminds us of this as he explains, faith allows you to hope in spite of the evidence and then watch the evidence change. I repeat, faith allows you to hope in spite of the evidence and then watch the evidence change. The question, my brothers and sisters, is, do you believe this? Do you believe in faith that in spite of the evidence we see, we can trust God and know that the evidence will change before our very eyes. Do you believe this? If we are people of faith, my friends, our answer should be a resounding yes. Let us therefore live our lives as a people of faith. A people who believe in the power of Jesus who was raised from the dead. Let us stop doubting and believe. Let us have faith in Jesus as the one who delivers, the one who heals, and the one who saves. Amen.
Amen.
Page 106, 106. Let us stand as we affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ,
His only Son, O Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
For our intercessory prayer, your response will be, and give us your peace.
And give us your peace.
Lord, we give thanks for all who, though they have not seen you, have believed. We give thanks for the disciples and your appearing to them in the upper room. Help us to know that you are with us in your risen power. We pray for Christians who are fearful of persecution, for all who are suffering because of their faith. May your church speak out boldly in the power of your resurrection. We pray especially for our leaders. For Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Howard, Diocesan Bishop and Archbishop of the West Indies, Robert and Leon, Suffragan Bishops, Winston, Ronaldo and Orlando, and to all others who hold office in your church. Christ, risen Lord, be with us.
And give us your peace.
We pray for all who are seekers after justice, freedom, and peace. Bless the work of the United Nations and all peacekeeping forces. We pray for Patrick, the Governor General, Andrew, the Prime Minister, Peter, Leader of the Opposition, and all members of Parliament, the Senate, councillors, and group leaders. Protect all who seek to bring new life and peace to troubled communities. We pray for community workers and all local councils. Christ, risen Lord, be with us.
And give us your peace.
We give thanks for those who taught us the faith, who shared their beliefs with us, We are grateful for all who have set us examples to follow. May we rejoice in your presence in our homes. May we show forth your power in our lives. Bless us in all our dealings and relationships. Christ, risen Lord, be with us.
And give us your peace.
We pray for all who are locked in by guilt or fear, all who are afraid to venture because of risk and danger. We pray for all who need healing of past hurts, for the healing of memories, for all who are suffering from losing loved ones through accidents, crime, or illness. We pray also for our sick and shut-ins, especially those in the Southfield cure. Christ, risen Lord, be with us.
And give us your peace.
We give thanks for all who have passed beyond death and rejoice in your kingdom, for all who have triumphed over sin and suffering and are now at peace. Christ, risen Lord, be with us.
And give us your peace.
During this moment of silence, let us pray for our needs and those of others.
Let us also bring to Almighty God all persons in this land and other parts of the world who have been affected by the coronavirus and are in need of God's healing. Let us also pray for the health authorities, the frontline workers of our country, as they seek to manage this pandemic. Our God heals, and our God delivers.
Blessing and praise be to you, Lord, our God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
By your great mercy, you have given us new life and new hope through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. You have brought us into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, and in heaven. To you be praise through Christ our risen Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and God will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Page 123, Form A. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The greeting of peace. Page 125, we use for C. The kingdom of God is justice, peace, and joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit.
They who thus serve Christ are accepted of God and approved by others.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
For the offertory, 165, 165.
Thank you.
for the presentation of the offerings. Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us, this bread and this wine. With them we offer ourselves, our lives and our work, to become through your Holy Spirit a reasonable, holy and living sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. For he is a true paschal lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death. And by his rising to life again, he has won for us eternal life. Therefore we praise him, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it,
Do this for the remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Thy kingdom come on earth, thy will be done.
we use a third form for the breaking of bread. This is the true bread which comes from heaven.
Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
At home and are unable to join us in this physical space to receive the sacrament, we are reminded that we continue to be nourished and be strengthened by God as our Lord and Savior. The hymn 578, 578.
Thank you.
Johnson. Recessional hymn 183.
Thank you.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.